What we see now is that digitalization and electrification is converging fully. More and more of our customers are going to these stretched electrification plans to take down their CO2 footprint. And in order to get to that full potential, you need to have confidence that the setup that you designed for actually works.
Today at Scania, we work with our customers in a very collaborative and consultative manner. And we do this not only with transporters, but also with a lot of transport buyers.
So when we get a customer case, the first step is usually to try to collect as much data as possible. We can also then, of course, look into the transport flows and try to understand their driving patterns.
We have more than 600,000 connected vehicles running globally every day. And through this process, we can predict what it would mean in energy consumption and in other aspects when converting from the combustion engine to an electric engine and that ecosystem. We have a unique collaboration with the Axel Johnson Group in Sweden. Here the focus is to help Axel Johnson understand what actions are required to go electric and to do it in a profitable and effective manner.
At Axel Johnson, we have very high ambitions when it comes to the climate and our impact on the climate. And reducing CO2 emissions is, of course, one of the more important things there. And we have a lot of transport in our businesses with food service and grocery chains and other retail, etc. So for us, that is a crucial thing to work with electrifying our transport fleet. In order to get progress, you need to think differently from what you've done in the past. So you need to be open-minded, ready to change. And I think that if you work with partnerships, it's easier to get new perspectives.